Hi guys, Mr. Awful Waffles here. This is going to be a guide for you to get the Hell's Retriever in Blood of the Dead. It's a different process to what we're used to from Mob of the Dead, and so I'm going to walk you through with really basic baby steps here, just to make sure that you get it absolutely right and you don't get lost or anything along the way. The Retriever itself is a really useful weapon. You can just keep tossing it out, obviously, and use it to kill zombies, and you can also charge it up if you feel so inclined as well, and after two pulses outwards of the kind of radial energy that comes off when you charge it, it will then be ready to go, and it will chain through more zombies and sort of stay out killing stuff for a little bit longer. You probably want to start this unlock process right at the beginning of your game, because it's going to take a little while to do. Reason being, we need to feed some hungry doggos. The first one, although you can do these in any order that you desire, it doesn't have to be this way round, it just probably makes the most sense, is gonna be on the spawn island, so fairly near where you spawn in on the map, and down in the room where they're building all the license plates. It's on the wall back there. You need to fill that up with 6 or 7 zombie souls, and you fill it in the exact same sort of way that you're used to from Mob of the Dead or from a map like Der Eisendrache as well. Once you've fed it enough zombies, the dog will make a certain sound and it will kind of retract back into the wall, and there'll only be a symbol of a dog head on there, and so you can move on to the next step. Bear in mind, and I know this might sound obvious, but a lot of people don't realize it, if you're killing zombies while the dog is eating, it isn't going to eat those extra bodies that you're trying to feed it. And in Blood of the Dead especially, if you're doing that, you're gonna burn through a lot of rounds before you get through to that final dog head, and so I'd really recommend that you're careful about how you feed it. 6 zombies, feed the doggo, sound cue, you're done with that dog. The second dog is in the regular area that we would recognize from Mob of the Dead, so you're gonna want to go to the old part of the map via the catwalk from the spawn, and before you go, one thing to note, you should turn on the power on that spawn island. It's pretty easy to find. Here it is in my game right here. Just flick that switch and you're all good. That's half of the map's power activated. Once the power's on, and once you're past the catwalk and you're on the old side of the island, and you're running up the little kind of walkway here, just as we remember from 2013 when this map came out, you can whip around the corner and you'll find your second dog head. You can just start feeding it straight away, no worries. Now be careful, because if Brutus chases you up here, things can get a little nasty, so just keep that in mind. Before you can begin feeding the third dog, you need the second power switch to also have been activated, because otherwise the door will be closed, you won't be able to get into the warden's office, and you therefore won't be able to go to the warden's house. To turn on this second power switch, go down these stairs outside the office and essentially follow where I'm running. One pro tip for you in case you're potentially playing with randoms or something like that is that as you're running down here, you can actually check how many dogs you've already completed and filled up on this wall. It's just a nice little thing to give you some peace of mind, almost like you forgetting that you've left the oven on, except you're forgetting that you haven't done the dog in spawn or something like that. It's a good kind of mini checklist. Once we're past that, we're gonna go down the big spiral staircase, which has the skeleton holding the spork in it now. Curious to see where that leads. And then once you get all the way down the bottom, running all the way down, you're gonna open up this door just here and head to the right. Now, as you go through, you're gonna look to the left and you'll see multiple power switches. One of them will be activatable, and so you just need to flick that switch. It'll randomize, so it'll be one of the three. Now that you've got both power switches on, you can follow the path we just took back up the spiral stairs and back to the warden's office. You'll then be able to go through the office and buy the 2,000 point door, which has the dog location just behind it. Now you just need to feed him, which you've already done for 2 dogs at this point, so this should really be straightforward, and once he's done, he'll go back into the wall. Then you need to step into the warden's house. If you hook around inside and take a left, essentially, you'll find a fast travel location, which should now be accessible. Enter it, and you'll fall underneath the map. As you travel, you should spot the Hell's Retriever just perched on a rock, and you have to hold square as you go past in order to pick it up. Congratulations, you've got the Hell's Retriever, and now you can basically just kill things with it for the rest of your game. It's great. Now, there's probably going to be an upgrade for this, and while it's not currently known at the time of making this video, Once we do know how to do it, I'll have a guide for you linked on screen so you can go right into that and upgrade it into probably the Hell's Redeemer. Thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully this very basic guide has been useful for you. If you've enjoyed it, then please drop a like and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.